Right, I just want to do a little bit of a walk around Brodsworth Hall, or the gardens rather. It's Bank Holiday Monday. It's beautiful, it's hot, sunny. There's a brass band playing, and you can see the people are sitting out enjoying it on the croquet lawns. There's the hall. Just going to wander up to the Victorian carpet bedding layout, which is looking spectacular at the moment. Beautiful scene. Mary Poppins has joined us. Oh, they've got the sprinklers on. Kids are loving that. Gardens are looking absolutely stunning. Let me get the camera wet. Fountain's not on, apparently. Pump's not working. Thank you. absolutely stunning colours. Let's go around the back to the laburnum arch, which is not flowering because laburnum's flowering June, and it's now the end of August. This is a relatively newly planted area. Nice euonymus, some nice autumn colour there later on. And there's the laburnum arch, nicely underplanted with begonias and coleus. This ace is new and provides an autumn focal point down that eye line. So around the windy path. I think we'll just take a look at the sunken garden. Or the fern dell. Come down here. Big redwood there. Metasequoia. Down in what used to be quarry. There's the entrance to the fern dell, but this is the range, the archery range. And this is all newly planted. There's the archery house. Canners are looking, everything's looking really good. Because we've had a fair amount of rain in August, and these last 4 or 5 days have been very, very hot. So we've got the sprinkler on there. So that down there was the target range. Lots of conifers down here. The archery house that was built from the remains of the old Georgian house that used to be on this site, because the present house is Victorian, mid-19th century. About, well, early to mid 1830s, I think, if I remember right. So we're in the rose garden, which is being replanted at some point. A fair bit of box blight here as well that they're having to deal with, but these borders at the edge are looking stunning with late summer colour. Butterflies are loving that. Is that Joe Pye weed, is it? I'm not sure. So warm down here. It's hot, so sheltered. Absolutely stunning. Most of the roses have finished flowering, because these are the actual old Victorian style roses, so this is as close to the original as they can make it, which means of course they only flower once, and that's end of June, early July. Although there is one or two that have got the odd flower on. Let's have a little smell at that. Oh God, that is fantastic. That is so wonderful. The scent on that, it's just beautiful. a nice little bridge over the path there. We come back to this big, oh well, big for the UK anyway, redwood. Let's go and have a look in the Ferndale. I like these little seats just under this bridge. People to sit on. Trachycarpus fortunii, loving, well, I think it's that's the one it is. Loving this sunny, sheltered spot. Another here with another couple of quaint seats, which bring you back to the archery range. It's quite a shady area, so again, lots of shady loving plants, anemones and ferns and hostas. There's the target house again, archery house, I think is what it's called. Steps, and I want to finish this off hopefully at the highest part of the gardens. And from the temple, there's the view.
You can't sell down here. Teach. Come on then.
There's the fern, fernery or Ferndale. Here's the rock garden. There's not a lot in flower, the rock garden. Very sunny site, gets sun all day, but that's a massive colour from May through to kind of early July. There's the estate land, grazing land. I think round here is the pet cemetery. Temple. Yeah, there's the pet cemetery. Right, I was going to finish filming up here, the last bit, but I'm going to walk down that path. But it's already on 22 minutes nearly, so I'm just going to carry on walking until it stops recording. Because I might be running out of space in a little bit on my phone. I'm going to walk back to the house and finish off, hopefully around the other side. So there's the temple. It's absolutely stunning. So, so impressive. So for my shaky camera work, because I'm walking. So this is the west facing frontage. That frontage on the right is south facing. So I'm going to walk down, as I say, until I've run out of space on my phone. Or until we get to the east facing front. Because on the east facing front is one of my favourite all time trees. And gives a magnificent impression as you enter the gardens. Well, we can just see it coming round the south facing front, that beautiful cedar of Lebanon. It's an absolutely stunning tree. It's huge. About 350 years old, apparently. There's the main entrance to the house, eastern side. blue of the cedar, set off by the yellow of this golden yew. Don't eat it, it's poisonous.
Actually, no, I don't.
Yeah, yes. The cones are just amazing. So there's the entrance, and you come up and you're presented with that.
Well, listen, I know an umbrella usually gets rid of the rain, doesn't it?
Stunning tree. And you come around on this path, and the house is framed by the tree. Absolutely beautiful. And there's the eastern and northern side of the house, which is where you enter the cafe, which used to be the servants' quarters, I believe. But I'm just going to finish off here now. We're nearly on half an hour of a quick tour around Brodsworth Hall Gardens. Finishing with that stunning cedar of Lebanon. Bye for now.